Is the new EX structure deck, Blue Eyes Evolution, worth it? Let's take a look.
You're a third-rate duelist with a fourth-rate deck.
Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Happy Duelings Anniversary and I hope everyone is having fun with the new celebration. A lot of Blue Eyes love this time around, so I have to talk about the new EX structure deck and see if it's any good and if it's worth to spend your free-to-play gems on it. Let's start with the new cards introduced in Blue Eyes Evolution. First up, we have the King of D, a card that can actually be pretty decent as a tech in a Blue Eyes deck, if of course there is enough room for it. Searching Melody of the Awakening Dragon and then searching again for two Blue Eyes can be pretty helpful. If it does actually see any play in competitive decks, it won't be more than one copy, which is very good for free-to-play players. Next up, we have Dragon Revival Rhapsody. While having a spellcaster on the field can be very possible for Blue Eyes, I do not see this card being an incredible tool. You definitely won't use this as a core piece of your deck, since it will make Blue Eyes more bricky, something you totally do not want to do because that is one of the main problems with the deck in Duel Links at the time. Maybe you can play it as a tech card, but I still do not think the card is great. You might prefer to use King of D as a tech if you had to choose one or the other, even though he needs you to waste your normal summon. The next new card in this structure deck is Shadow Spell. Even though this isn't a Blue Eyes specific card, it is still a very good addition to the structure deck. I am sure many have compared it to Fiendish Chain, and yes, the similarities are obvious. Continuous traps that also prevent attacks. But Fiendish Chain is still the better one of the two, because it allows you to negate effects as well. Shadow Spell is focused more on weakening the opponent's monster, so you can destroy it the first chance you get. Still a very decent staple though. Finally, we have Blue Eyes Twin Burst Dragon, a contact fusion monster that can be summoned by two Blue Eyes White Dragon on the field. The card was already available through DSOD Kaiba's skill, Ultimate Dragons, but now it can be placed directly in your extra deck. Another very good tool for the Blue Eyes extra deck, and you won't need more than one or maximum two copies. So as far as new cards go, this EX structure deck is actually pretty nice for free-to-play players. But let's also take a look at the reprints. The Whitestone of Ancients is a core 3 of in every Blue Eyes deck. Spirit of White is another great card and can also be played at 1. It actually is being played at 1 in the majority of the Blue Eyes decks. Cards of Consonance will probably be the main issue for free-to-play players, since it will most likely be needed multiple times to provide drawing power. Finally, Azurai's Silver Dragon is another core piece for the extra deck and is mostly being played at 2 copies. Ultimate Providence is another non-specific Blue Eyes card that is very decent in different types of decks, but it is a rare, so nothing crazy that is actually included in here. I have to say that I like what Konami has done here. The reprints are very good and the new tools are not actually needed multiple times, making the deck accessible for free-to-play players, but also allowing players that want to spend a couple of bucks to get most of the old core cards they will need. Do not get excited yet though. Blue Eyes is a very expensive archetype to build optimally because it requires many ultra rare and super rare cards from old main boxes, and not all of them are actually included here. Blue Eyes Spirit Dragon and Sage with Eyes of Blue are both core cards played at 2 and 3 copies respectively. Good thing is, both are actually included in the same main box, Judgment Force. As I already mentioned, you do need 3 Whitestone of Ancient, but at least this card is from a mini box. Finally, the deck runs some staple cards like Karmakat and Raigeki Break, while also having Vermilion to complete a very strong extra deck. So if you have been building Blue Eyes all this time and have majority of the old cards needed, this EX structure deck is absolutely worth it for you, even if you are free to play. But if you literally have none of the old cards, wasting 1000 gems here is a bad idea, because you won't be able to play a viable Blue Ice deck with just one copy of the Structure deck. As far as meta viability goes, Blue Ice will definitely stay in the tier list, but we have to give it some time to see how good the new support will help it perform. I think that the free addition of Alternative Dragon is a big deal, but all of us have a copy of that. My tier list will be published this week, but all the new support won't be actually taken into consideration yet, since it is very new. And these are all my thoughts on the new EX Structure deck. Do you like Blue Eyes as an archetype, and are you happy with its release? Tell me in the comments down below. For more advice videos on Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel to not miss future content. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.